I'm Dakxin Chhara. I'm a theatre practitioner and filmmaker. I made more than 84 documentary films, and we did 46 plays in the community. I belong to the Chhara denotified tribe. Before I go into my presentation, let me share an incident happened actually to me in 2006. I was assigned a photography assignment actually by an NGO called Bhasha Research and Publication Center. It's a Baroda-based NGO. To take a photograph of religious places of the nomadic communities in Gujarat. So for this purpose, I was in a small town called Tharad, and I was documenting Lord Shiva's temple. And there was Mela also going on. Kafi saare log, hajaro log wahan par the. And suddenly few people actually came to me with sticks. And they brutally beaten up to me. They slapped me. Yahan se, wahan se, sabhi jagah se. They dragged me actually from the temple and off campus, jo hai campus ke bahar, they thrown up to me. And I could not understand. I was really shocked that what I have done. I asked them that what I have done, why are you doing this with me? And one of the person, he slapped me again and he said, where are you from? And I said, I'm from Ahmedabad. What are you doing? And I said, taking photograph. No, no, but from Ahmedabad, where are you from? In which area? And I said, Charanagar. One other person hit me at the back. And then I understood, okay, what was the problem? Why they were doing with me this? They were doing with me because I belong to the certain community which is still treated as a born criminals, as a criminal tribe, because of the, due to colonial stigma. Let me briefly introduce an stigma. Birth, like year 1871, which is also birth year of the denotified tribes. These denotified tribes were like a nomadic tribes in the different part of the country. And this was the year when these nomadic tribes actually got new name by the British. And that name was born criminal. The stigma, they branded nomadic tribes as a born criminals. There were three reasons. A, they were coming from the sedentary society and they could not understand that why people are moving from one place to another place. For them, person or group of people, they are moving from one place to another place, for them they were always suspect. For them, they were criminals. But they could not understand the nomadic civilization of this country. B, they wanted cheap labor. And they wanted to build big infrastructures like railways. Yahan par Pune ki jo bhi railway line hai, this entire railway line was actually done by the denotified tribe, like ex-criminal tribes. And C, they could not understand, you know, this nomadic civilization. Under this act, they branded more than 200 communities across the country, and they put into the different settlements. The settlements were like rabbit-proof fenced areas, and the most punitive section of the act was if they arrest me as an individual in a stealing or thieving or, you know, in roaming here and there. They had a power, the village headman had a power, the police and judiciary had a power that they can arrest to my family also. And also they can arrest entire community and they brand them as a born criminals, as a criminal tribe. And they have to spend like generation into the settlements. In this way, people spent their generations into the settlements. 1947, 15th August, we got independence. But I'm sorry to say, unfortunately, my forefathers did not get freedom on 15th August 1947. The independent government, they appointed a committee to recommend whether these people should be free from the settlements or not, or whether the act should be repealed or not. It is really unfortunate. Because I heard that when India got independence, prisoners were also free, you know, from the prisons. But these people, my forefathers, they did not. The committee took 5 years and 16 days to give recommendation. And finally, on 31st August 1952, 5 years and 16 days, they finally they repeal an act. And my forefathers, actually, they got free from the settlements. By that time, these nomadic tribes who were jugglers, dancers, singers, acrobats, transporters, like Banjaras, you know, their livelihood was already gone. By 1952, the Constitution of India was already in implementation. And remarkably, these all tribes were completely missed out from the constitutional guarantee. I saw the document in British Library in London, in which the committees recommended to the government that the Criminal Tribes Act should be repealed. The Criminal Tribes should be replaced with the act called Habitual Offender Act. So one act got repealed and another act actually came in independent India. And we become a scapegoat. Still, that act is still going on, the Habitual Offender Act. It's a 1959 act, and under this act, kisi ko bhi, koi bhi police, without any kind of warrant, they can come to my home, they can interrogate to my parents, they can beat to my parents, and they can arrest them. I was also called so many times, actually the police chowki, the police station in my area. So this was happening in 1959. After 1959, so many committees set up to recommend whether what should be done actually with these ex-criminal tribes. Unfortunately, their livelihood was gone and people started petty crimes. My father was a great thief. My parents' generation, they were all parents were doing actually thieving, stealing, because they did not have any option. There was no acceptance in the mainstream society and they were not educated. But in 1980s and 90s, these all so-called thieves, they collectively decided that our next generation should not be thieves. And they made us educated. I was educated while my father was actually thieving. My many of friends, they were educated in that way. In 1998, it is also a very important year in the denotified tribals movement in the country. Now, in 1998, Mahashweta Devi, noted Bengali writer, I'm sure you must know about her, and Dr. G.N. Devi is a very known linguist. They both wanted to work actually for this invisible population on the government record, this invisible population for their constitutional guarantee. And they heard that Charas are the most educated, like Banjaras, they are most educated people in Gujarat. And they wanted to meet us. They were detained at the police chowki for 1 hour. But Mahashweta Devi was Mahashweta Devi. She entered into the community. Police said that you will be robbed by the police. But when she entered into the community, she found that, oh, there is a 10% primary education. There are so many advocates, lots of education. And they could not understand that why we, like Charas, are still treated as a criminal tribes, as a criminals. They wanted to help us. And they asked us, we want to help you. What do you want? And we collectively said, books. We want books. And Mahashweta Devi gave us library, a small library in the community. She died last year and she's always in my memories, you know, because of her presence, because of her initiative. Today I'm speaking here. And we got courage to speak on the stage and, you know, to the world. We got the library. In the library, there was a magazine called Budhan Newsletter. In that magazine, I read a Justice Rumapa's judgment about the Budhan Sabar's custodial death in East India, in Purulia district. And I was told to make the play, Budhan. I written and directed the play. It was 1998, and today is 2017. It's the third generation in my community where they're still performing Budhan play, and Budhan become an identity of my community, like play become an identity of my community. Now people, most of in Ahmedabad, at some extent, now people treat us as a good actors, dancers, singers, filmmakers, journalists, not as a thieves, because of that play. Apart of Budhan, we did a lots of different kind of forms, different kind of plays. We did 46 plays, and we performed thousands of shows across the country, and our demand was constitutional guarantee through theater. The theater became a bridge between the mainstream society and system and our isolated community. People started to work actually to come to the community, because earlier, before 1998, jo bhi wahan se nikalta tha, aise muh pe laga ke chala, because my like many of people actually in my community, they also brew liquor. The deshi liquor jisko bolte to bahut baas aati hai, to log wahan se naak ban karke nikal jate. They never wanted to come into the Charanagar where I live. The theater became a cause actually for the rest of the world to witness my community, and they found that, oh my God, these are the normal human beings. They are not criminals. They're educated people. And slowly, slowly, the perception, the stigma, the colonial stigma on my tribe was slowly, slowly removed. I want to show you some of the clips of our performances, and then I will continue my presentation.
बहुत टाइम पहले से चालू है।
हाँ, किसको हफ्ता देता है तू? हाँ, किसको हफ्ता देता है?
सब किसी को नहीं।
हाँ, हफ्ता क्यों नहीं पहुंचा? और पुलिस
और विमुक्त जनजाति का आदमी सिर्फ यही सोच रहा है, उसके दिमाग में सिर्फ यही सोच चल रही है कि क्या वो सेकंड क्लास सिटीजन है?
क्या वो
सेकंड क्लास सिटीजन है?
क्या हम
सेकंड क्लास सिटीजन है?
क्या
हम सेकंड क्लास सिटीजन है?
हमें चाहिए आपका सम्मान, हमें चाहिए आपका सम्मान, हमें चाहिए आपका सम्मान।
So we want self-respect, we want respect from the mainstream society. Are we second-class citizens? This question we are asking since 18 years to the society and to the system. We performed in Delhi, we have George Fernandez's house, we have played in the streets, we have played in the streets. If someone broke the DNTs, then we have corporation, the AMC, the AMC commissioner's house, also performances in the AMC, also in the AMC. One day, we have done 36 shows, the sound was sitting, the gullet, खत्म हो जाते थे, but we were keep performing, keep performing, keep performing, because we always wanted to ask, are we second class citizen? Because still, the denotified tribal who constitute almost 16 million people of this country, 6% population of this country, are still invisible in government record. They don't have a constitutional guarantee at all. My father, before 2 years, he got heart attack. And routine check-up जो होता है doctors का, वो doctor ने पूछा कि आपको कोई तकलीफ थी, ये था वो था सब, तो उन्हें कहा कि नहीं नहीं मुझे कोई तकलीफ नहीं थी। And quietly he called me and he said that Dakxin, I cannot say to doctor that what happened to me, लेकिन आज से 17-18 साल पहले जो जिस तरह से हम लोगों को मारा गया है, ये police used to hit on the feet. और ये मार जो है ना उस 15-17 साल के बाद हार्ट अटैक के माध्यम से निकलती है, मतलब ये पीछे से निकलती है मार, एंड यहाँ पर मारने से किसी को खून नहीं निकलता है, तो यू कैन नॉट प्रूव दैट एट्रोसिटी हैज बीन डन ऑन द पर्टिकुलर पर्सन इन द ज्यूडिशरी। बोली ये मार निकल रही है, लास्ट ईयर ही डाइड ड्यू टू हार्ट अटैक। सो वी हैड लॉट्स ऑफ एंग्यूश एंगर, whatever happened with our parents, whatever is happening with me or with us, जब भी किसी की चोरी होती है तो किसी को भी randomly पकड़ के पुलिस चौकी पे बिठा दिया जाता है, वो कैसे चलता है, कैसे खड़ा रहता है, क्या बात करता है, उसकी recording करके लोगों को दिखाया जाता है। The government also publish a book in the name of the charas, that these are the charas and they are the, you know, they do a thieving, and उनकी photograph उसके अंदर है, किसी की भी चोरी होती है उनको दिखाया जाता है, which is unconstitutional, illegal. But ये anguish था, anger था, but we did not responded our anger in a violent way. We responded our operation non-violently through theatre. We performed this kind of atrocities, police atrocities, mainstream society की जो भी atrocities होती, we performed. We openly talk with the dialogue, you know, have a dialogue with the mainstream society. We also performed in the police academies and trained the police officers, IPS officers through theatre, and always appeal them that don't consider as a criminals. We are a normal human being. आदमी अगर criminal बनता है तो उसके पीछे कोई ना कोई तवज्जो, कोई ना कोई कारण होते हैं. Please try to go into that. Don't just, You know, colonial stigma is still going on, and don't just treat us as a criminals. And we trained more than 15 IPS officers and 300 police inspectors regularly in the police academies. We had anger and we responded non-violently. Our catharsis, actually, we wanted to bring out our catharsis. And we got empty space within. Theater gave us voice. Theater gave us space. Voice to speak out, space to struggle. These both things actually come together on the stage. Not this kind of stage, but on the wherever we got the corner, wherever we get the space, that is our space, and we struggle. We speak out there. And as we speak out, people listen that. The government also listen that. And because of that, the Budhan Theater became a cultural wing of the denotified tribal movement in the country. Even Dr. Manmohan Singh also came to know about Budhan Theater, and he personally discussed with Mahashita Devi that I am aware that how much these all kids are actually struggling through theater, and they're conveying message, whatever the happening with them, actually to the country. So this is what we have been doing. Through theater, we also fought cases, legal cases. Like we come together, and our DNT Basti in the Maninagar, which is a political constituency of the Prime Minister of the country, Sari Basti told Diti, and we filed the case. We did a place, we collected money, and we filed the case in the High Court. We won the case, and the AMC actually challenges in the Supreme Court. Due to theater, due to our performances, many advocates actually came together and they said, we want to help you. They help us in the Supreme Court, and we finally won the case. I'm sure you will be happy that today, like before just week, more than 2,000 people, they were moved from the Basti to the good houses, the flats. And this all happened because of theater. Theater became a voice of the oppressed communities. Mahashweta Devi died last year, but her monument is built in Gujarat. Unki asthiyan lai gayi thi, aur Gujarat mein TEDxHindujaCollege naam ka ek gaon hai, Baroda se 100 km dur, wahan par unko dafnaya gaya tha, unki asthiyon ko dafnaya gaya tha. And she said that har sapne ko jeene ka adhikar hai. Ye unki jo smriti hai usme likha gaya hai, har sapne ko jeene ka adhikar hai. If your dream die, you are gone, you are lost everything. So at the end, I want to recite a revolutionary poem, actually, which is written by Pash, the Punjabi poet. Mehnat ki loot sabse khatarnak nahi hoti. Police ki maar sabse khatarnak nahi hoti. Gaddari lob ki mutthi sabse khatarnak nahi hoti. Baithe bithaye pakde jana bura to hai. सहमी सी चूप में जकड़े जाना बुरा तो है, पर सबसे खतरनाक नहीं होता. सबसे खतरनाक होता है मुर्दा शांति से भर जाना, ना होना तड़प का, सब कुछ सहन कर जाना. घर से निकलना काम पर और काम से लौटकर घर आना. सबसे खतरनाक होता है हमारे सपनों का मर जाना, हमारे सपनों का मर जाना. सबसे खतरनाक वो घड़ी होती है जो आपकी कलाई पर चलते हुए भी आपकी निगाहों में रुकी होती है. सबसे खतरनाक वो आंख होती है जो सब कुछ देखते हुए भी जमी बर्फ सी होती है, जिसकी नजर दुनिया को मोहब्बत से चूमना भूल जाती है, जो रोजमर्रा के कर्म को पीती हुई एक लक्ष्यहीन दोहराव में खो जाती है. सबसे खतरनाक वो चांद होता है जो हर हत्याकांड के बाद वीरान हुए आंगनों में चढ़ता है, पर आपकी आंखों को मिर्चों की तरह नहीं करता. सो साइलेंस इज हॉरिबल. And when art becomes silent, I think that is the more horrible in the country. We wanted to speak out. We wanted to break that silence. And theater gave us the dignified life. Today I'm speaking here because of theater. Because of theater, so many people in the denotified tribes, we developed 7 theater groups, and now people become filmmakers, journalists, working in the corporates because of the confidence they gain in the theater. So theater for us is our dignity. The process of the theater for us to divert our energy in a positive way and to remove all the negativity within. So theater is important, and theater must be practiced you know, oppressed communities in order to speak out their problems. Because when you speak out, somebody listen, and somebody listen, they think, then something will happen. Thank you so much for inviting me.